This is a time of remarkable growth in the department. Over the past 5 years, we have recruited 15 junior faculty members. At the university, we've tripled the number of full-time faculty. Many of these new faculty are people with scientific interests in addition to their clinical interests.
We have synergy with our new people and with the people who've been here for a while and who are loyal to the department, and that brings in lots of opportunities for clinical growth, research growth, and teaching residents and medical students.
One of the most important things for a department such as the department that we have here at the University of Minnesota is to offer tremendous clinical care. Our faculty are very well known throughout the country as well as regionally. For the clinical expertise in many of the who's listing nationally for otolaryngology, regionally and locally, magazines every year list their favorite docs and their top docs, and you'll find that many of our faculty are on those lists. We have flagship programs in many clinical areas, including otology and neurotology, which is a study of hearing loss, in facial plastics and reconstructive surgery, as well as in pediatric otolaryngology. Our head and neck cancer program, which is a program directed towards the treatment of tumors in the head and neck, is also very well known and growing very strong.
It's really exciting. The department has grown recently in some very specific areas. We've brought in a fellowship trained laryngologist who will be dealing with voice and swallowing issues, and she's really excited about her area of expertise, and also will be working with some of the residents doing a lot of research. We also are hoping to bring in a sleep medicine specialist, which is a very common problem in our patient population. And all of us do a little bit of work in sleep medicine, but it would be very nice to have somebody who's dedicated to treating our patients and hopefully doing some research as well in the area of sleep medicine.
Our residency and fellowship training programs are terrific. We take 20 residents in our program. We have four every year for a length of training of 5 years, so that's 20 residents. In addition to the residency, we have three fellowship opportunities, one in pediatric otolaryngology, which is based primarily at Minneapolis Children's, one in facial plastics, which is based primarily in St. Paul, and our otology program, which is based here at the University of Minnesota. Our goal with our residents and fellows is to train them to become leaders. If our residents choose to become doctors in the community, we would like them to be leaders in their practice, to become leaders in their hospitals, and to become leaders of the regional medical societies. If our residents opt to become academicians, we would hope that they would lead through interesting science, through novel discoveries, and through developing improved clinical practices. The way that we think we can do this is through mentorship.
I've been fortunate to have excellent mentorship, and I've learned a lot from Dr. Yu as a chairman about how important mentorship is. His mentorship for all of us has really been the key to our growth and our success and our happiness.
Research is part of the fabric here at the University of Minnesota. We've had a long tradition of making discoveries and developments that have benefited our field. We want to continue that in the future. We think of our research as being important in three fundamental areas. In head and neck cancer, our scientists are working to prevent cancer in those who are destined to get it. In hearing loss, our scientists are making the discoveries and our clinicians are delivering the care that will enable the deaf to hear. And in reconstruction work, we want to be able to rebuild the faces and function that will allow people to restore their lives. One of the unique features that this department can offer in terms of its research is the clinical and outcomes research. Most departments across the country will perform some kind of clinical research, but what we're hoping to do here is to bring that kind of research to a whole new level.
Clinical research that we're doing in the department here at the University of Minnesota is unique in that we actually have an infrastructure, and we meet on a weekly basis, and each of the faculty who are involved in the clinical research is able to present their project and learn from the other people in the department, you know, how could I make this project better. Several of us have been through the School of Public Health program in clinical research, and that adds to both our knowledge and credibility and our ability to successfully implement our research projects.
I think what's really special about this place, however, is its people. For such a old department, it's remarkably vibrant. What this results in is a department where talented individuals really come together in a comfortable collegial environment to create something much bigger than any of us could do on our own. This is just a fabulous, fun place to work.